Hello everyone, Christian here. Shopify's new starter plan is only $5 a month. Some of you have been asking to see how it actually works. So we're gonna build a brand new from scratch store using the starter plan. Now, a while ago, we talked about the Shopify starter plan and all of its benefits. So if you want a more thorough breakdown of that, you can check out that video here. But just to kind of give you a quick synopsis, it gives you just a simple storefront. You get the start theme, and this is something that you cannot necessarily edit. It's just a very simple, bare bones storefront. You get unlimited products, you get a checkout page, you get a contact page, you have access to apps, and you can also run reports, and et cetera. So I would say the biggest difference between the starter plan and like the next one up, which I think is the basic, it's the ability for you to have sort of a full-blown website for you with a domain and all that kind of stuff. So the starter plan is really for someone who is starting on social, or maybe you have started on social and then you have an email following. So that combination of like your central base is on social media, whether it be YouTube or Instagram or Facebook, right? And you want to monetize your audience, then this plan is going to be for you. So now that we have that out of the way, we are going to sort of recreate our totally 90s kid test store. And again, this brand is aimed at millennials, AKA the 90s kids, with just fun t-shirt designs. Actually, the product that I'm gonna add is nothing like that, but just kind of wanna give you a synopsis, right, of the brand. So with that in mind, I just wanted to let you know, again, this brand, we're creating it because we have created a Facebook page. And we just kind of post memes on Totally 90s Kid, and we want to monetize that audience from Facebook and actually create some products and share some products with that audience. So what we have here is we have Shopify.com, and we're just gonna click on start a free trial. Let's get started. Which one of this best describe you? I'm just starting. What would you like to sell? An online store and social media, definitely Facebook and Instagram. Let's put TikTok in there too. Product that I buy or sell myself. What would you like to name your store? So let's do, I think we already have Totally 90s Kids. So let's do Totally 90s Kids. We're located in the United States. And then now we have to create a Shopify ID. And what we'll do is, let me see if I can log in through my work email and password. Okay, so it's gonna create our account. So it looks like Shopify has a pretty good deal right now where you can do 3 months for either the starter or the basic plan for just $1 a month. So if you're watching this, I think this video comes out in January. So hopefully you still have this deal because it's actually really, really good. And that also, you know, covers our starter plan. So let's go ahead and pick a plan. Scroll down a little bit, you'll see starter in here. It gives you our offer. So typically it's $5 a month. So, but for now, it's for $1 a month for 3 months. Again, payments, just want to clarify because we did talk about this in the other video, but payments, third-party transaction fees, if not using Shopify payments, is 5%, which is crazy. Online credit card rates is 5%, 30 cents, which is crazy. You get shareable product pages, one user. You also get discounted shipping, just like any of the other plans. And you get all these things right here. So if you want to do a screenshot of this, you can, but we're going to choose this plan. This will actually give you a notice in here. It says you will keep any product information you've added, fast and secure checkout. You will lose any customizations to your current online store. So again, going back to the actual theme, access to custom themes and some apps, and then online store, the theme editor, yep, pages, blog posts, custom navigation, and product collection. So yeah, it's quite a lot, right? Like I said, you're not getting a fully realized website here. I'm gonna go ahead and click accept and understand, confirm, and then yeah, we'll do monthly. We'll confirm this information. I'm gonna go ahead and fill out our business and payment information. And we'll see you here in a second. Now, before we keep moving forward, I just want to say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Piñon, one of the co-founders here at Bit Branding. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. We drop new videos every week, so make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out. Now, let's keep going here. It's asking us, how did we hear about Shopify? I'm going to say other. Okay, so now really what we want to do is kind of follow the setup guides to some extent, right? We definitely want to add our products. We want to add our logo. configure our sales channels if we have to, Shopify, set up the Shopify payments and all that. So we'll go step by step and we'll go setting everything up, and then I'll show you how to connect everything to your social media channel. So let's go ahead and add a product. Okay, so I have the information over here on my other test store. So we're just gonna do this one because I have the most information, or the most complete, right, information. Gonna ahead and copy all this, paste it right there, add some files, those two. Boop. Pricing, we're gonna do $44. Product category, shirts and tops. So this new product category has to do with the US tax rates. It's gonna be very, very important in order for your store to calculate taxes automatically for you. So you do want to review these. It will automatically give you what's recommended based on the title of the product, the picture, and the actual description. So it's doing a really good job, shirts and tops, right? That's exactly what it is. So you can accept that suggestion. And then beyond that, you can also do your own product type. So for us internally, this is just gonna be tops. Vendor, let's just do bit shirts. And then $44, cost per item, it's gonna be 13. Inventory, so if we have some SKU numbers in here, we can put that in here. I do wanna track quantity. Location, we have 12 available. This is a physical product. When it comes to weight, you do wanna make sure that you put something in here, especially if you have calculated shipping rates, because it will take the weight of the item into account when it's doing all those calculations. So it's very, very important to do something like this. So I'm just gonna do 40 grams. Country of origin, we're gonna ship it from right here. So we're gonna do US. This shirt does have options, and that is what's being recommended right there, which is size. And then we have it in small, medium, and large. Something to take into consideration, whenever you're coming up with sizing names, it's good to just keep it consistent all throughout your store. Because when it comes to filtering and sorting your products, when it comes to the collection page, obviously you probably won't need this in the starter plan. But when you do move forward and get into the basic or more advanced plans, then keeping the same values and having some sort of set of rules, right? I've seen stores that have small, medium, large like this, or sometimes they abbreviate it by just SML or like two letters. So just keep that in mind when you're building out your store and adding your products. Click done on that. And then now that we have those options, then it gives us the variants in here. So we can actually say we have maybe 10 of these. We have 6 of these, and then we have 8 of that. So it looks like we have everything available there. We're gonna click save on that. And there it is. We have our first product added to our store. As far as the next step here is obviously brand assets. So this section, they've actually moved it around. Before, this was non-existent, but now because you have the starter plan, because you have your default logo and different things on different places, like Linkpop and other places, then they've added this sort of central location for all of your brand assets, like your logo, et cetera, and all those things. So I'm gonna click on add a default logo in here, added our logo. And then a couple other things you can do, you can add your primary colors. So for us, definitely have some hex codes, but I don't have them readily available. But if you do have some hex codes, I'll definitely put those in here. Contrasting color, let's do a black. So you can add cover images, you can add your slogan, short description, and then any of your social media links, which we're gonna go ahead and add that. So let me look up on Facebook. I'm gonna copy that link, go back over here, add a social link. I'm gonna do Facebook and add that link right within here. I'm gonna save that. So we're gonna close out of that. Now configure our sales channel. So we're not gonna necessarily set up the Facebook and TikTok. If you are interested about setting up your TikTok sales channel, we do have a video on how to do that. And that just gives you the ability to have that shop tab on your Facebook page in order to have your products connected that way. We're gonna go ahead and the next one, which is the Shopify payments. Shopify payments allows you to essentially just capture payments. Now, before we continue setting the Shopify payments, I do want to basically tell you about something that we've been working on for a little bit now, and that is a Shopify VIP day. Well, the Shopify VIP day will give you essentially access to us in order to create your Shopify store in one day. You heard that right, in one day. Now, as we are still gathering more information, and solidifying our processes, we do want to open it up sort of as a wait list, right? So if you are interested in getting your Shopify store from the ground up, from zero, into a fully functional website where you have your logo, you have your products, you have everything, your about page, you have your payments connected, your taxes, so everything's taken care of for you, then check the link down in the description below where we're gonna open up a wait list just to kind of gauge on if it's something that you guys even want, right? We've been thinking about this for quite some time, and I think it's gonna bring a lot of value to y'all, and especially it's gonna bring speed, right, to your process. So you don't have to necessarily be stuck for a long time on X, Y, and Z. We'll walk you through the whole process and get your website launched in one day. So again, if you're interested, check the link in the description below. Now, Shopify Payments does require some information from you. So if we click on the complete account setup and then submit details in here, you'll see that it will ask you about your business type, whether you're a sole individual or private LLC, corporation, etc. It will ask you about your EIN number, it will ask some personal details, your product category, customer billing statement, etc. So it's gonna want some information that you may not have readily available. So again, if you do have all this information, then I would highly suggest to kind of grab it beforehand. Any sales tax information, any type of business verification, anything like that, to add it right within there. And then the other biggest thing is going to be your bank information. So you'll want to have your routing number and your account number ready to go so that Shopify can insert funds into your bank. Now, next up is your shipping settings. So again, because we set up the grams for my products, I am going to do the automatically calculated rates. So to do that, actually Shopify gives you like these generic ones right here, which they are just flat rate based on the weight of the product. So it goes from 0 to 5 pounds and it gives you $4.99. You don't have to keep these, you can definitely get rid of them. Same with like the rest of the world. If you don't ship rest of the world, you can definitely get rid of those rates. And then I would highly suggest some form of free shipping, right? And again, if you have questions about how to offer free shipping, we have made some videos on shipping and just more in depth on shipping policies. I think I'm gonna leave this just how it is right now and not do the calculated rates. But again, if you're interested, we have some videos on everything that has to do with shipping. But yeah, it looks like Shopify already gives you some generic parameters in here. I would probably won't leave this in the long run, but just wanted to let you know that. So I think that looks good. The next one is to remove the password and then show your product. So let's go to online store. I'm really curious to see how this looks in here, because this is typically where you would, you know, manipulate your theme and all that. So okay, it looks like it's just the start theme. Looks like they're on version 1.3.1. Looks like you can manage your branding and then look at the preview, and that's it. I'm gonna go ahead and click remove password. Let's click on view and see how this actually looks. Wow, this is very simple. So it's just a logo, the shopping cart, a social media icon just kind of floating there randomly, the products that I have, and then the payment information. Wow, this is crazy. But I mean, that's what we're paying for, right? It's just a very straight, simple store for you. So, and then the other thing would be, I don't think that I can do, let me go to settings, a domain. Okay, so it looks like we can add a domain, which is good, right? Because I mean, we have this storefront. I think we should be able to add a domain. So I think right now I don't have any domains that I can necessarily like connect real quick. But from the looks of it, it seems like we can connect a domain and not just like leave it like with the .myshopify.com, which you can use this. Like there's no wrong reason why not. Well, you couldn't use that essentially. Now, I mean, you have that set up, you have shipping, you have your payments, you have your products added in here. You can't manipulate your theme or anything. You can manage your branding, right? So if you click on there, it'll take you back to this page under the settings. But besides that, I think the only other thing that I wanted to add and show you in here is Linkpop. Since we are essentially, for this brand, we are living inside of Facebook. That's our home base. I want a quick way to showcase all my products without necessarily having to connect Instagram, Facebook, or TikTok or anything like that. And with Linkpop, we can do that. Let me go to the App Store. By the way, if you have more questions about Linkpop, I just kind of name drop that. But we've also made a video on Linkpop. So if you have questions about Linkpop and how this all works, you can check out that video here. But Linkpop essentially just like a link tree where you have all your links all in one place. And it looks quite neat, and it's good because it's made by Shopify for Shopify stores. So it just makes sense, right? To use this instead of something else. Hey, if you like what you see, please consider clicking on that like button. All right, so here we have Linkpop. All we have to do is continue to Linkpop. Okay, so it's just connecting to my page. You have the option to create your own profile page URL. So if you wanted to do something simpler in here, you can. I'm just gonna leave it like that, create profile. Wow, this actually has changed just a little bit since the last time we made this video. This actually gives you a preview in here of how this will look. Because we only have one product, it's only gonna show us that one product. But right within the actual links that you can create, you can add products, you can add media, you can add other links to other places. And again, you can style it in here. It looks like it grabbed the logo and the styling from that brand page that we already had, which is kind of nice. All of our social media links we can have right here within the top. Excellent. So I'm gonna click on, just open it in a new tab so we can copy that. And essentially all we're gonna do is just grab that link and put it in our, whether we had that Facebook page, which you can see right here, just adding that Facebook, like that link right within here as our website. That way anyone can access our products from our business page. And then we can do the same with our Instagram. We can add that to our link in bio. We can add that to our TikTok link in bio and link our products that way. Makes it super easy. You don't have to necessarily connect anything. You can get started. I mean, we just did this very quickly, right? So as long as you have all this information ready and good to go, then you can get started with the starter plan. Like I said, it was kind of a quick video on navigating through all this. And I was actually really curious on how this section right here, the online store, actually looked. So now you have an idea of how this store looks and feels. So it's very, very basic. You don't have a lot of options and anything to really move around. So hopefully this was helpful for you. If you have any questions about the starter plan and you'd like to get started, please let us know down in the comments below and we'll make sure to help you out. See you in the next one.